Well, we're now going full blast, aren't we? Full blast. It should be Evan. I'll tell you how full blast it is. I actually jog today. That's right, jogged, jogged. For the first time in years. I got some emergency. Someone just said, "Guess what? You're going on a trip soon." I said, "Oh my gosh, I'm not quite ready for that." You know, I've been dieting now for almost well, it's been 2 months, really, 2 months. Been dieting for 2 months now, and lost 15 plus pounds. And I decided I've been stretching, and now today I realized someone told me, you know, "Hey, you're going on a trip, really nice trip. Get ready." Huh? Okay. Got the jogging shoes out, went jogging. It was brutal. It was brutal. And the Holy Spirit has been tricking me, wonderfully tricking me into starting to run. I left a gate open again, a different one where the dogs could get out. And I was working. I looked at it and said, "Oh my gosh, I left the gate open." And so I had to sprint. I sprinted. So I sprinted this distance, long distance. I sprinted, and I said, "Hey." Closed the gate, and I said, "That wasn't bad. I can do that." And so the last couple of days, the Holy Spirit's got me running, tricking me into running. And now I say, "It's not so bad." So what did I do today? Finally, I've been trying to do this for years. I couldn't get the will to do it. I'm doing it. Get this. I'm not watching the World Series. I haven't watched a minute of the World Series. If this isn't a sign that we're now in the time, in the end times, then nothing is. I mean, this is our opportunity. If I don't watch the World Series, you know that I'm extremely serious. It's one thing to skip the Super Bowl, which I've been doing, but to skip the World Series, that's unthinkable for me. But I am doing this because we are in absolute go time mode that has been revealed to me with great clarity and reinforced over and over now, that those who want to drag us down into heavier density, you call them the reptilians, the cosmic corporate culture, the Dracos, the unholy alliance, as it were, in this world that is. And we all know what we're referring to in general, that they are now making their full move, all chips on the table. Because they know their time is short. They're trying to counteract the fact that it's for us, it's light body time. It's time to see ourselves as light. And so this is the crucial. We're in about, you know, an 8 month period now. So November, December, January, February, March, April, May, June, 8 month period, an 8 month period, where this will be decided, you know, for us which way we want to go. So it is the extraordinary time right now. And you know, I'm giving everything I got. I'm still drinking the juice and kale smoothies in the morning. I'm hardly eating anything. I'm lightening up, exercising, starting to run, just, you know, doing everything. And I just put a blog posting of all the lessons of A Course in Miracles in just a text format, so you can just go through them. Do 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 do. I'm gonna try to do that. I still haven't done that. I'm trying to get myself to do that. I keep telling myself every day, you just go over them every day, like, you know, at least once or twice a day, all the lessons in the workbook. Just refresh your mind, refresh your mind. I met someone today, a very, very nice man. And he said something very, very odd to me. He says, "Hey, where are you from? New Jersey or New York?" I said, "What? I've lived here all my life." And he says, "Well, where'd you get that accent?" And I said, "What accent?" He said, "Well, you're used to speaking with an accent." And I said, I didn't even realize that." I said, maybe I just picked it. Maybe I picked it up from somebody I was speaking to earlier or something. I don't know. I said, "I'm that way. Whoever I'm around, I accommodate them." This happened to me a couple of days ago. Someone spoke in an accent to me, and I responded in the same accent. And I caught myself. I said, "What am I doing? What am I doing? You know, why don't I just respond in my own voice?" But I spoke because I like to accommodate people. I'm naturally accommodating, but this is a big problem. And then he said he has the same problem, that that whoever, you know, whoever we're around, we become like that. And I told him, look, it's been a lifelong problem for me. That means that's why I have to be very careful to stay away from bad character and bad situations and try to surround myself with the best character possible, which is why I've tried my whole life to just focus on the saints, because I easily can start accommodating bad people too, in terms of, you know, behavior, body language, talk. I just sort of am like a, I just am accommodating that way. You know, I meet them at their, wherever they are. This is how they talk. This is how I am. And then someone's a, you know, very, you know, a great, you know, liberated sage. I try to accommodate, be like that, accommodate them. So it's best to surround yourself with the great sages and the saints. And, because you will become like them. At least I certainly am like that. And he said he has the exact same situation, and you got to be very careful. So it was really quite extraordinary. And this reminds us, by all means right now, focus on the great sages, the great saints, and just say, hey, these are my friends. These are my friends. Why? Because they're helping me see myself as light. Now, we hear about in the end times, we're going to be changed in the blink of an eye into incorruptible light bodies, right? Well, I think we've all kind of said, oh my gosh, this is scary. But I just had an insight. The Holy Spirit just showed me the truth of it all. And it's just simplest thing is imaginable. We just simply recognize in a blink of an eye, oh, what we thought was flesh really wasn't flesh at all. It's really light. It's just light. We are light. Everything is light. We're light bodies. And we've always been light bodies. And it's just kind of like, oh, so that's it. Very simple. There's no some big dramatic where the flesh like boils away and are suddenly, you know, gets, you know, something happens to the... No, we just recognize, oh my gosh, that was just an illusion. It was never there. Oh, I'm light. I really am light. So this is the time to do, as I say, do the lightened up. We're really going to do this. I know I'm going to do this. There's no question. So do the lightened up. You just, and it's just like a smooth, one moment you think you're flesh, the next moment you decide, you know what? I'm tired of thinking myself as flesh. I'm going to think of myself as light. And you'll realize, oh, I'm light. This is what I am. It's that simple. It's that simple. And of course, this light is incorruptible. We realize that I am the light. I am the one authority. There is no other. I am incorruptible. I am perfect. I am flawless. I am the light. I am the flawless light. I am the flawless light right now, and all of now is right now. I am the flawless light. This will happen for us. Absolutely. This is what the reptilians and their cronies here in this world don't want us to do. You know, they don't want that. They're trying to default and say we can't go back to the light. It's ruined. You know, we ruined it. So if someone goes back to the light, it proves that they didn't ruin it. You know, they don't want that proof. They don't want that evidence, because then they get the continuity fear. Then they'll be faced with their continuity fear and go, too much continuity fear. But that's it. No problem for the Holy Spirit. You can lay all the Draco continuity fear in the universe on the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit will just laugh and say, it's already done. I already did it. I already freed them from their continuity fear. So we don't need to feel guilty or sorry, you know. It's, you know, we should have this no more guilt movement. You know, there's all this stuff about victimization and guilt and stuff there, because they get money from it. They get power. They're using it as much as possible. Guilt. You're guilty, guilty, guilty. Guess what? I don't have any guilt. I sold all my guilt. It's gone. The Holy Spirit has dissipated it. I don't have any guilt. I've never victimized anyone, and no one's ever victimized me. Everybody is complete, their own sovereign authority over their own experiencing. So all these people who try to lay all these guilt trips on us, like, you know, you owe us this, you owe us this, you owe us this, you're guilty, 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 you know, this is nonsense. This is a lie of heavy density. When we see ourselves as light, we realize that guilt is impossible. This is what A Course in Miracles teaches us. And Jesus tells us that guilt is impossible. Sin is impossible. You've never harmed anyone. No one's ever harmed you. No, there's no cause of guilt whatsoever. So this is how you forgive yourself forever, believing that it is possible. To believe it's possible for us to be victimized is to believe that everyone else is possibly victimized. So it's really hating everyone. To say that I cannot be victimized is saying that nobody else can be victimized either. That's loving everyone, okay? So Trust in the great teachers. Trust in the great teachers. Jesus is teaching us truly. Truly he is. He says if the eye be single, then the whole body be full of light. What he really means is if you shift into the non-dual perspective, there's only one will. I am that will. There's only one authority. I am that authority. There's only one light. I am that light. I am that light. This is the eye, the single eye. Okay, he means the single eye. Seeing just oneness, okay? If you see this perspective, then you will see that you are indeed, your whole body is indeed light. So it's very simple. See? Very simple shift. You'll recognize, oh, my body's light. There's only one light. There's not two lights. There's only one will. There's not two wills. There's only one authority. There's not two authorities. Okay? Now, I had this terrible dream last night. I woke up in the Bronx. Awful, awful, awful dream. Good Lord. And I struggled with it all morning. It was such a heavy thing. And it was another projection that I had to, I was calling back home and they were coming back home. But, you know, it was nasty. Now, I had to uncover, like pulling a carpet off of something, you know. Under the carpet was so much junk. I mean, it was just horrible. It was just horrible. That was October 27th. It was the evening of the 26th of October. It was that evening. And I was just, it almost sickened me how much junk had accumulated there. And I said, this is all my stuff. I've been driving along with all the, oh God, you know. So it's like pull up the carpets in your vehicle, right? The foot carpets, and look what's underneath there. Well, this was like a million times worse. It was, and so, I realized if I clean this up, I cleaned it up and I've said it's clean. It's clean. It's done. So these projections coming home, they're nasty. They're not nice because we projected all this in an attempt to deceive God. And mine was really terrible. It was ultimately it was a man. It seemed like it'd be a man who was a very nasty man, like a pig, you know, really piggish man. And he really was. He was just lived a bad life and a very piggish life. And pigged out on everything, wine, women, and song, you know. One of those types, you know, like a roux, you know, a dirty old man, pig sort of guy. Just pigs out on the good things in life and frequents brothels and feasts and eats whatever he wants and smokes and drinks and, you know, just a bon vivant, you might call him. Yeah, there's many, many people like this. They have this persona throughout history, bon vivant, but a piggish sort of person, you know. And I just said, this is horrible. This is terrible. How can I invite them into my home? How can I invite this into my home? But later on in the day, I got something that just said, whoa. And that is the Dracos, the reptilians, and their cronies are, of course, trying to hook everybody using these devil women, to say the least. And I said, wow, if that pig man is still out there, you know, hasn't come home, he's going to get hooked by these devil women. There's no question about it. I mean, these are devilish hookers, so to speak. And I said, hey, come on home, welcome home, get inside, you know, shut the door and go sit there by the wall and just be quiet and be still. And this is what happens when projections come home. Then they become utterly still and quiet. As long as our projections are out there, still projecting them, we will still be experiencing disquiet and confusion because they keep getting hooked and doing their thing in the world. And so, and we're worried. It's, oh my gosh, I don't get pulled that way. It's like Velcro, you know, and we get hooked and get pulled. So we'll put all our Velcro inside. And so I said, get inside now. Wow. Because it is full on right now. The danger is full on. Nobody wants to be that bon vivant. Call the bon vivant back in. Back inside. So you cannot be hooked that way. This is crucial. And so I got over my reticence. I said, hey, welcome home. I'm glad I called you home. Thank God you've come back home. Welcome home. My house is your house. And I'm the sole authority here. So I'm saying you just go sit and be quiet now. Your piggish days are over. That was just a projection. We cannot afford the appetites of the flesh at this point anymore in this world. Absolutely cannot. This person that was symbolized the appetites of the flesh, okay? And so just like the tiger symbolized the whole personality of the intense, you know, animal nature of survival of the fittest, kind of, you know, wary and clever and cunning and just the overall personality, this one symbolizes the appetites of the flesh. And this is someone who just wants to pursue the good things in life for the flesh. And so I said, that's it, you know, no more of that. You're home. I'm calling you home. You're finished. That's it. No more projection. I'm not projecting any of that anymore. So you will find that these projections, as they come home, this very unsavory, you know, just yuck. You mean, oh gosh, it's your past. It's your past. Just like if you look under the liner in your trunk, for instance, in the vehicle, under your trunk, pull it up and look what's in there. Oh my gosh, all this stuff that you stuffed in there and it had slipped and fallen and dirt and everything got in there. If you usually use your vehicle for a long time, I mean, it's terrible. You can see some rocks and dirt and this and that. And well, it can get worse and worse and worse and worse than that. So our projections tend to be very nasty, but once all the chickens have come home, we've invited them in, ultimately death itself will come and we'll call it home and we'll say, come on in, be quiet, be still, you're no longer active, you're inert now, death. If we don't do this, we're going to get hooked by this full court press that's taking place right now. The Holy Spirit has pointed out, this is now started, October 27th, it started. Because our time of blessing has started, and the reptilians realize that, and they say they're trying to counter it. You know, they're working to counter this. So we better be, you know, lean, very lean and mean, and full of right habits right now. And so my purpose, well, we'll see what my purpose is. Maybe it's even more. Well, I don't know. Is it more? Is it less? Whatever it is what it is. But we're doing the lighten up right now. We're doing the lighten up. And hopefully everybody has taken all the clues from all these videos that realize this is not a rehearsal anymore. This is not a rehearsal that's taking place right now. This is a full-on attempt to collapse this world into heavier density. Full-on. And they are not fooling around. I mean, these people are desperados that are doing this. They are desperados. Make no mistake about it, and you know, so we have to be, you know, very vigilant, and I wish I could do a million times more for everybody. I'll try, because we could all use it right now. We could all use it. I mean, nobody wants to go down into heavier density, okay? This is not a trip that we want to go on. You know, it's kind of like an adventure. We say, I think I'll pass on this one. I think I told you, I said before that, you know, attempts have been made to drag me down in my life for sure. And some have worked better than others, and some, you know, fortunately I sidestepped. The heavier density always tries to drag you down. It makes them feel safer. They don't want anybody succeeding. They want to believe the light is gone. They don't have to go home. There's no home to go home to. And they think that'll cure the continuity fear. If there's no home to go home to, they say, well, you know, then I can just stay where I am. I don't have a continuity problem. So this is their upside down, backward, insane logic, you know, based on an insane premise. It's logical if the premise was right, that there's no more light, but the premise is wrong. So it's fundamentally flawed, inherently flawed, the way they're looking at things, the situation. So I don't know exactly what to do. I just pray to the Holy Spirit is how to help out. Now is the time. Now is the time. Starting October 27th, it's all on. It's all out. And to help us all out too. I mean, we have the capacity now to just say, "Hey, I'm light." That's it. That's what I said on the 27th. I just started saying, "I am light." That's what I am. I'm light. I decided to feel, not think that I'm light, to feel it, to experience. I experienced myself as light. Also, I was tying my shoes, or I was taking off my shoes after the run, I think. Or was it before the run? One of the two. And I just said, I wonder what myself is really like, the true self. And then I just had this, I started to look, I wanted to look and see, and then I sort of experienced it. After a moment, I glimpsed my true self and just said, "Wow, that is so nice, it's so kind." And that is our true self. And so we need to start looking at that. And talking about hanging around good company, hang around your true self. That'll start rubbing off on us. It's there. It's there to look at, if we're willing to look at it. I just sort of took a glance. I want to know what my true self is like. I said, "Oh, okay." And you can't really explain it. You have to experience it. It's just too good for words. It's just too kind for words. It's just too gracious for words. It's just so you have to just look and experience it a little bit, and just say, "I am this light. This is what I am. I am the light. I am the light. There's only one light, and I am that light. There's only one true light, and I am that light." Electromagnetic realm is just light, true light pretending to be something other than what it is. That's all. That's all. And just claiming that this is light. It is electromagnetism. It's not light. It's not really light. We're just calling it that. I am the true light. I am the one and only true light. There's only one light, and I am that light. There's only one authority. I am that authority. So if I start running, it means it's time to pick up the pace. This is what it means. It is time to pick up the pace. And so we just got to do it. It's something will get you to do it. The Holy Spirit will trick you into it somehow, just like it tricked me into it. I better start running. Time to pick up the pace here. Time to start going all out really fast. Because the other side is going really fast. And the other side, I'm meaning those who prefer the notion of curing our continuity fear by trying to claim that there is no more, there is no home to go home to, because everything is so dark. They say it's so dark, how can there be a home to go home to? It's crazy to even think that way, right? They want to make it so dense that we say, well, there couldn't possibly be, our home couldn't possibly be still be standing. How could we be in such a dark, dense place? And they think that this will then liberate them from continuity fear, and then they'll be happy, because everybody, whether they know it or not, is tormented by continuity fear. They don't know, they may not know what it is, but there's this inner torment. It's continuity fear. It's fear of our home that torments us. So they think if we just make things as dark, super, super dark and nasty, then we will conclude that, well, there is no home to go home to. There's no light to go, there's no more light. So we don't have to go home, so no continuity fear. And they think that then the continuity fear will vanish, and then they'll be happy. This is their idea of liberation. It's upside down, backward liberation. And so you don't want to go that direction. As I've been hammering away at this for my whole life, you don't want to go that way. If you hang out with people who are going that way, you're going to end up going that way. That's why I stopped watching TV. I can't watch TV anymore. I can't listen to the radio anymore. I can't watch the news, look at the newspaper, the internet. You got to be very careful. Just go to the verified websites that you know are spiritually safe. I've tried to put some up, the blog. I don't know if the blog has any advertising on it. It might not, which is really nice. This YouTube has advertising on it, but the blog doesn't. Not a lot of visitors there, but I'm trying to set up someplace where it's just, there's no advertisement or anything. It's just pure. And so you hang around as much purity as possible, and then you begin to become like that. You feel comfortable with it. You get familiar with it. We need to get familiar with purity right now. We need to get familiar with purity. So, again, no World Series. And it, don't think that you can somehow avoid it. No, they sneak it in so many ways. They're so sneaky right now. The devil is so sneaky. And which is just a plan of heavy density to say there's no more light, no more home. This is it. We're stuck. This is home. And then we say, oh, gee, that means we don't have any continuity fear because we don't have to go back home. Oh, we're liberated. And of course, home still does exist. Light still does exist. Therefore, the continuity fear still exists. And we have to evaporate it, work at it. So their way seems to be quick and easy. Let's just drag everyone down to heavy density, and then automatically the continuity fear will be gone. It doesn't work. The way that works is to evaporate the continuity fear bit by bit by bit by bit. This is the way home, because home still is, and light still is, and we have no choice but to stop pretending we're something other than what we really are. We have no choice in that whatsoever. So the devil's way is folly. Okay, it's folly. Satan, devil, Lucifer, duality, continuity fears. It's really just a dance of continuity fears, all it is. This is absolute folly. It's listening to continuity fear instead of listening to the Holy Spirit. This is the problem. When we listen to continuity fear, it'll say, oh, I know how to get rid of me. Just realize that there is no more home to go home to. And then you won't have any fear of going home because there isn't any home to go home to. You just stay where you are, and you're already familiar with that. So that should solve the problem. This is how continuity fear talks to us. Jesus calls it the ego. I use the term continuity fear because it seems to hit home very intensely because it's Jesus used the term ego because at that time everyone was super focused on psychoanalytic theory. And believe me, I was back th there then, and I was also super focused on analytic theory, and all the highbrows were, and so he said, oh, played along. I was okay, it's the ego. But now 2015, for me, I say the continuity fear is a dance of continuity fear, because this is literally what it is. We're afraid to go back home because of a lack of familiarity with it. We're so used to the density and darkness that we're just afraid of lightening up, That's all it is. That's all it is. That's all it is. And this can be worked on as we have and work on. We're walking together in the wow is how we work on it. The reaction, the path is just wow. You keep hanging out with purity and you see it and you see it better and better and you just say, wow. Wow. First time I saw Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma, her pictures and video actually, I just said, wow. It was an overwhelming wow. I said, this is someone who's 100% pure. I said, I've never seen anyone in the world like that. This is extraordinary. And it just knocked me out with a wow. And then the wow reaction, A Course in Miracles, wow. Ramana Maharshi, wow. Longchenpa, wow. The Adi Shankara, wow. Buddha, wow, Jesus, wow, come on. It's the wow. It's not so much an intellectual thing. It's glimpsing purity. It's glimpsing what we are. Even though it may be vague and make it vague quickly, still we get just this feel, a quick little feel, oh wow. This is true. Truth is still true. Home is still home. It's still there. It's still there. Wow. I thought the continuity fear is telling me it's not there anymore. It's lying to me. Wow. So, of course, we fill in the blanks with some intellectualisms and words and concepts and such, but ultimately the path is just wow. That's all it really is. That's why I say this is walking together in the wow. It just, brings tears to your eyes sometimes. Just, oh my gosh, this is so pure. This is so true. I'm not, we, I didn't lose myself. I didn't lose reality. I'm going home, and once I get home, I'm home for good. And this has just been a short detour in fear, but so wow. And so we should ramp up the wow, ramp up the wow, ramp up the wow. So don't think you have to figure it out. It's not so much a figuring out, except it's an experiencing. And the wow is the experience reaction we get from taking a glimpse at purity, at truth, at love, at peace, at reason, at home, with God. And it's getting just a little, you know, hit of that, a little buzz, the buzz off of that. And then when we, and asserting it, say, I am that, I am that, I am that, I am that, I am the light, I am that. This gives us a buzz. This buzz is the wow. This is a spiritual buzz, not a drug buzz, a spiritual buzz. Don't need, you know, don't want to go into drugs at all. Get clean from drugs. Just like I told that man today, I said, hey, I have to live really clean. I can't hang out with bad people. I cannot. I have to live a very, very clean life. And I do. I absolutely do. I guard my thoughts. I guard who I hang out with. I try just to stay away from anything that isn't. And it's difficult. I mean, who do you hang out with in this world? You know, so I pretty much stay away from people because they're bad influences, honestly. Not that they're bad spirits. It's just that their preference right now is to try and, you know, follow the vice of the continuity fear. And that's a bad influence. It's a very bad influence. Then it seems real tricky and smart, doesn't it? Hey, we just, you know, just hang out in heavy density for a little while and poof, magically continuity fear is gone. Don't have to do anything to make it evaporate at all. It'll just disappear because we're not going home. It seems very smart, doesn't it? It seems really, really smart. Say, well, that's really smart. Yeah, but it's following a completely false premise. And that's not smart at all. That's not truly smart. It may seem, you know, very slick, but it's also very stupid. So, you know, and yet, you know, it people don't see it. They don't see it. They don't realize it. They're still haven't had that. Oh now I see that. Wow. Because to them, this is just the height of sophisticated intelligence. Oh my gosh, we see the way. Let's just hang out in heavy density. There is no home. There is no light. Continuity fear is gone. I won't be tortured anymore. I'll be happy. But how are we going to be happy hanging out in heavy fear? And then, you know, even if it did, even the continuity fear was gone, you know, that just means we'd keep hanging out in heavy density forever. And is this what we really want? No, no. Continuity fear is a good thing right now because it reminds us of home. It says, I'm afraid to go home. It's attraction to home. Once, if that attraction was gone, that wouldn't be a good thing at all, would it? It would be a terrible thing. Oh my gosh, I have no more attraction to the light to go home. I just feel like, you know, like a lizard hanging out here in heavy density. Let me just stay here like that, like comatose. Oh, is that a good thing? It's terrible. So we're happy that the continuity fear is still agitating us and causing us problems. Very happy about that. It reminds us of home. Yeah, and when we get a glimpse, oh, wow. That's really wonderful. Wow. Wow. Yeah, just wow. Maybe I'll do a video, help out, right? I don't know what I can do to help out. Ultimately, you know, not ultimately, but definitely see myself as just light, you know, and then people will experience a wow from that. Not people, spirits. Spirit will say, oh, wow, I just got a glimpse of something that I can do it too. I just realized that I can do this. Wow. I just realized it's easy. Wow. You know, this kind of stuff is very, very helpful. So, but by all means, just for somehow allow yourself to be shocked into the realization that it's go time. Go away from time. Go away from the belief in flesh time. No more flesh. I don't see any more flesh at all. Say that. I don't see any more flesh at all. Flesh. I don't see any flesh anywhere. I don't see any matter anywhere. I don't see matter. I don't see flesh. I only see light. That's it. And of course, this is what the demons of density, the density demons, they don't want this. It scares the, you know, bejesus out of them. I mean, they don't want this, you know. They just say, stay away, stay away. It undermines their whole premise, what they're trying to do. And so they get all frightened out of their cords. But that's okay. Holy Spirit's got it covered. Yeah, I'm feeling hungry. That's a good thing. It's just, it's a good thing right now. I'm feeling tired. Yeah, because I just ran. I've been stretching. And yeah, that's a good thing. It's a good thing now to feel, that you're putting yourself through the ordeal. This is great. This is great. This is what we want. This is glass half full time. I feel wonderful. Look at that. I feel achy. That's great. I was worked out. That's great. I'm just going for it. That's great. We shouldn't feel all, lazy and sluggish and complacent right at this point now. This is full on, battle for the battle, really spiritual battle, full on right now. So bring it. Absolutely. The battle is to bring us down. And hey, they thought I'd watch the World Series. Guess what? Oops, not watching. They're not happy about that, saying, "Oh, we had all these great commercials and all of we set it up so wonderfully to entrap so many." And someone's not watching. I'm sure they're, fuming over that. Not watching television at all, no way, no way. I stopped watching TV. Can't afford to take the risk. The stakes are too high right now. You cannot give them, slack. Can't give them any slack right now. They're all in. They're all in. Their aim is to pull us down into heavy, heavy density. And so our aim is to go to lighter, lighter density. That's it. There's no, see, in this world, there's no more middle ground, like let's just stay in normal Earth density that we're used to. That doesn't exist anymore, actually. You're either going to go to heavier density or lighter density. That's it. So we better get going to lighter density. Pull out all the stops. We'll see. We'll see how we do that. Pull out all the stops right now. So don't shrink away from the task at hand. I know the viewership has gone down. Maybe because of politics or something, but keep in mind, I'm not really talking politics here. I'm talking this density struggle. And everyone has to understand that there are some politicians on one side and there's some politicians on the other side. Okay, this is just how it is. There's a density struggle taking place here right now. Very severe density struggle. Jesus said the worst ever. And ultimately, politicians, they're. I don't talk about it much because generally they're not, even the ones that are on the side of lighter density are not the greatest examples, I mean, we can do better. We can do better. Put your attention on the saints, the sages, and the highest, put your attention on the highest. But there certainly are those engaged, everyone's engaged in this density thing, and politicians have a lot of influence over people, over this world, a lot. And so I've pointed out from time to time, look out. There's certain politicians that are cronies of the heavier density folks. God bless each and every one of them because the Holy Spirit's already saved them. Keep this in mind. Holy Spirit's already saved everyone. They just are still following the false advice of continuity fear. Once they see through this, they'll flip over and go towards lighter density for sure. They just don't see it yet. They keep thinking that they have a better way, and they don't recognize it's based on a false premise. All thanks to Jesus Christ for pointing this out, to me at least, yeah. And of course, he didn't come in a vacuum. He came in. We're all helped by all the great teachers in history. Everyone who's helped to lighten, help us towards lighter density has helped us out. So all praise to all those who have helped us out. And again, everyone's already been saved, so don't worry. Don't worry about all these folks that are going into want to go to heavier density. That they'll get out of it. They'll see. The Holy Spirit's already saved them. they're just honoring time a little bit longer. That's all. That's okay. It just, you know, but we're not going to do that. So, you know, it don't take offense. Don't take offense in just pointing something out about this density struggle. The idea is you know, it's shock treatment. Wake up. We cannot go down. We cannot entertain the lower, heavier densities, no matter who is presenting it to us, no matter who the presenter is. I don't care what their politics are or whatever, you know. If they're presenting heavier density to us, you know, forget it. And whoever is presenting lighter density to us, thank you. Thank you very much. You know, it's that cut and dry right now. It's very black and white right now. Okay. And the thing is, some politicians say, hey, we don't have to take this. You know, we're not robots. We can say no to this. We can say no to this guilt trip they're trying to lay on us to pull us down. You know, it's honestly, I don't know if at some point it will be clearer, speak clearer about this, but this is nonsense. We just say no to guilt. Say no to guilt. I don't care who's telling you you're supposed to feel guilty. Say no to guilt. You know, the gangsters are saying that they're gangsters because you made them that way. You know, no, we did not. Nobody made anybody any way the way they are. Everyone's made themselves the way they are. Okay? This is a fact. This is a fact. You get these low density, these beings that the Holy Spirit has already saved, these spiritual beings, that are in perfect standing with God just like we are, and yet they're following the advice of continuity fear and going down to heavier density, and some of them have been down there for quite some time and telling us, hey, you need to come on down here with us. If you don't, you're guilty. Well, guess what? No, we're not. No, we're not guilty of anything. Right? It's just guilt trip that these heavy density beings and their cronies have been trying to lay on us. We're not guilty of anything. Okay, just tell us, I am not guilty. Just say this. Say, I am not guilty of anything. Say, I am not guilty of anything. Say, I am not guilty of anything. Absolutely, I am not guilty. So say it. I don't have any guilt. I don't have any guilt. I don't need to do anything to get rid of guilt because I don't have any. I've never done anything to feel guilty about. I have never done anything to feel guilty about. Say, I have never done anything to feel guilty about. Say, I have never done anything to feel guilty about. And this is coming from, of course, the scapegoat itself, you know, the elder white male of certain, you know, privilege and standing in the world, where they want to lay all the guilt on us, okay? All the guilt, historical guilt, we're to blame. Why? Because they want to pull us down, because we're the ones who seem to be most aiming for the lighter, you know, lighter densities, right? Light body, lighter densities, because we've worked at it, right? Not just us, others too, but they're using us as an example. Say, hey, if they can pull us down, they can pull anyone down, right? They can pull us down, they can pull anyone down. And they're trying to use a guilt trip on it. They say that we're, you know, we caused this. You know, we're the cause of all the world's problems. No, we're not. We're not the cause of any problems. Nobody's the cause of anyone else's problems. Nobody can cause problems for anyone else. Ultimately, we're absolutely free. I am the sole authority. Okay, over my experiencing, I am the one and only authority. There is no other authority. I am it. I am it. Period. There is no other it. There is no other it. I am it, just like everyone else is it. Also, nobody can do anything to spirit. Spirit is absolutely free. Absolutely free, and this freedom can never be harmed, never be changed, never be touched. So how can anyone feel guilty? This is what Jesus tells us. This is the truth. This is the truth. And Jesus knew there's this huge guilt trap laid on the world to drag us down to heavier density. Guess what? I'm saying we are not guilty. Nobody is guilty. No one is guilty of anything. Okay? No one is guilty of anything. Right? There's no victims. No one's ever been victimized. No one's ever guilty of anything. We're all just on a pretend trip. We're pretending. We're pretending that we're not free. We're pretending we're not perfect. But pretense is our own choice. You know, we're not judging anyone. Everyone's free to choose what they want. I'm not judging or condemning anyone. I'm just pointing out the truth. This is what Jesus tells us. Just point out the truth. You know, hate the sin, love the sinner. Sin, projection, pretending. We're pretending. And projections, we're pretending through projecting. Is that the projection separate from what we are? No, it isn't. No, it isn't. Something happens to the projection. It's because we chose to have it. So there's no second self. There's no second will at work here at all. So all this personality guilt that's being thrown at us, no, none of it's true. None of it's viable whatsoever. Nothing has ever happened to us that we didn't choose to have it happen to us. We chose to try to fake out God. Say, oh God, I'm being victimized. I can't be the way that you. I can't be the light. I can't be the truth. I can't be the way. I can't be the authority. You know, I don't have a home, so I must be this, you know, this flesh. You know, therefore, continuity fear must vanish for me. Oh, guess what? It doesn't work that way. It doesn't work. Jesus tells it that doesn't work. Plain and simple. He'll tell it to us a million times and a million more times. It doesn't work. No possibility of ever working. So we can't play this halfway game. Well, yeah, I'm a little bit guilty, and so are you a little bit. No, there's no guilt. There's no guilt. I have no guilt. I am the light. I have no guilt. I am the light. There is no guilt in me whatsoever. I am the light. I am the true light. I am the one true light. I am the one true light. Say, I am the one true light. Say, I am the one true light. There is no guilt in me. There is no guilt in me. Say, there is no guilt in me. Say, there is no guilt in me. I am the one true light. All are the one true light. Everyone's the one true light. Everyone's the one true light. There is no guilt. Guilt doesn't exist. So, you know, there is this agenda, huge agenda in the world to turn this, you know, victimization, planet guilt. You're the bad one. You're in, and you know, they're trying to attach this guilt to the ones who are willing to go with the truth, right? Lighter density, light body, light density. Because that blows their whole premise up, you know. They don't want their, because then what will happen? They'll feel continuity fear and say, whoops, the way we've been trying to do doesn't work. And they say, oh my gosh, I got too much work to do. No, they don't. Just got to get after it. That's all, you know, stop being so lazy. A lot of activity out there. Okay, so that's all. Just stop being so lazy. One moment, please. And yeah, they'll say, oh, it's too much cognitive fear. I can never undo that. Well, guess what? The Holy Spirit's already done it. It's already undone all of it. It's just that we're honoring time, so it seems to take time. So there's no one who hasn't already had their continuity fear completely undone for them by the Holy Spirit. No one. So their claims, I can't do it, is completely bogus. Don't believe it. Don't believe it forever. Not even for a moment. Don't believe it. Totally false. But they're trying to say, look how terrible I am. Look how hurt I am. Look at this. Look how I'm a victim of all the terrible things you've done to me, and you're so guilty. But if you go down a heavier density, I'll forgive your guilt. You know, this is what they're saying. If you go down a heavier density with me, I'll forgive your guilt. Don't buy into that at all. Jesus tells you, don't buy into that at all. It's a total, total lie. There's no spiritual truth. There's no truth to that whatsoever. But this is what they're trying to say, right? You know, what happened? Elect me president, and I'll forgive your guilt. You know, I'll right? Here, follow me down into this dark, dark tunnel, and I'll forgive your guilt, all the terrible guilt that you have, you know, for victimizing me. You know, yeah, right? This is what's been going on. This is what's been going on. Yeah, it's time to start speaking truth to this nonsense. Speaking truth to this nonsense. We don't have to put up with this nonsense. We don't have to agree with this nonsense. Time to push back. Yeah. I don't have any guilt. Deal with it. because they live on guilt. They think guilt's their savior. Why? Because they say, I can't go home. How can I go home? I can't. I must not. If I'm guilty, I'm not spirit. Plain and simple. But if we believe in guilt, we believe we're not as God created us. Plain and simple. Because God created us completely free to experience whatever we want to experience. Never stuck in any experience ever. Never pushed into any experience ever. Therefore, we cannot experience anything other than what we choose to experience. It's impossible. So if we say that we did, in other words, that means that someone's guilty because they forced an experience on us, then we're saying we're not as God created us anymore. We changed it. Somehow it changed. And therefore, we can't go home. And therefore, we think that our continuity fear will vanish when we accept this. So there's two ways to go in the world. Say that there's guilt or say there is no guilt. It's cut and dried, black and white. That's it. It's the only way. That's the choice. That's the only choice. Either we accept that guilt is true or we say guilt is not true. There is no guilt. To say that guilt is true, you're going to go down heavier density. To say there is no guilt, you go into lighter density. Intermediate step. And, continuity fear is still there a little bit, so we go into lighter density. And light body, and ultimately we realize we don't even need a body at all. We're just the light. That's all. We're just the light, not even in the form of some sort of what we'd call an entity or a body or anything like that. We're just the light. The formless light is what we are, ultimately. But that's not our goal. Our goal, light body, we would say, is our goal. Lighten up and realize the body. It's just this light. I am the light body. I am the light body. Say, I am the light body. Say, I am the light body. Say, I am the light body. So here, we don't even give the other side guilt an opportunity to speak back to us, do we? Now, the problem with following politicians is you get the given, they get on shows and you have both sides hammering at each other and stuff, and it kind of, you're enthralled by it. But here, we don't give the other side any even an opportunity, a chance, because we know it's not true at all. We know what their game is. We're not playing that game, okay? That's our preference. That's our right. That's our choice. We're spirit. We're free. I'm not a body. I am free. I'm still spirit exactly as God created me. So we prefer to go to lighter density, plain and simple. The other choice doesn't work because it's trying to make continuity fear vanish by claiming there's no home to go home to. That doesn't work. So we're not going to give what we know doesn't work an opportunity to lobby us, No, we're not. So I refuse to be lobbied by insanity. I say, I refuse to be lobbied by insanity. Say, I refuse to be lobbied by insanity. That's my preference. I refuse to be lobbied by insanity. I have the right to refuse to be lobbied by insanity. I refuse, say, I refuse to be lobbied by insanity. But we certainly thank the politicians and all the people who have started to pull back from the edge abyss, and say, hey, we don't have to go over that edge. We do not have to go over that edge and collapse into heavier density. We do not have to do that. All right? Your guilt doesn't work on us anymore. Your guilt does not work on us anymore. Guilt doesn't work on us anymore. But the doggone news, it's so toxic. It's so toxic right now. Stay away from it. Don't think that you can, don't try to, don't give the opportunity for the other side, the guilt trippers to lobby you. Don't give them the opportunity. Because that's all they're going to do. Don't think you're going to change their mind by listening to their lobbying. And they'll say, oh, there's a nice, fair person. No. Because what they're saying is, hey, we're sure of our position. You come on down here, admit your guilt. Come on down to heavy density, and we'll forgive your guilt. And we do that. You realize there is no home, and you can't go back home. There is no light. There is no truth. But your continuity fear will vanish, and you'll feel blissful and happy, and, this kind of they're crazy. Now, don't give the insane the opportunity to lobby you, because they're going to try, and they don't understand they're operating on a false premise. So they think their logic is good. Well, it's good logic based on a false premise. Therefore, it's completely inherently flawed. More than flawed, it's insane. It's not flawed, it's insane. So don't give the insane an opportunity to lobby you, because it's toxic. It's toxic. You're not dealing with people with a full deck at all. You're dealing with those who are insane, who believe in guilt. So Jesus says, stay away from them. You gotta just gotta sidestep them. And this is what we're aiming here, aiming for. Gotta sidestep them. Seriously, don't give them the opportunity anymore. It's tough, like going into Home Depot. Hanging. I mean, holy cow. I don't want to go into Home Depot anymore. Really. Toxic people are everywhere. They're everyone is so dragged down. You know, where do you go to find somebody that is just, you know, lightening up, truly lightening up, and just says no to guilt? No, not going to give you a chance. You know, false premise. See, once you see it's a false premise, that's it. You know, you need to repent, and ultimately, in fact, the Holy Spirit's already solved your continuity problem, so this is ultimately the path that you will go on. So I wish you Godspeed, but I'm in a big hurry now, and I can't entertain insanity right now. You know, so guilt, victimization, heavier density, solving the continuity fear that way is insanity. Nothing other than insanity. There's not a drop of sanity to it. Not a drop of sanity to it. So I can't drink that drink, you know. It sucks all the sanity out of me. It's a black hole drink. You know, say, here, have a drink of a black hole. You know, no thank you. No thank you. Lighten up. Go truly green, which is to lighten up. The way to go truly green is to realize you're light, okay? These other folks, United Nations, these folks, they're not going truly green at all. We're going truly green. Go totally green. I am a light body. I am the light body. I am the light, and I am a light body, and I don't have any needs. I have zero footprint here. Zero footprint. Even though I appear to be here, I have zero footprint in reality. None of us leaves a footprint in reality. Reality has no footprints in it whatsoever. There are no traces or residues whatsoever. It's completely fresh. Every instant is totally fresh. No instant leaves a residue or a trace in another instant whatsoever. So that's going totally green. So we need to go totally green here. I'm enjoying this. I hope you're enjoying this video. Absolutely, I'm enjoying it. What could be funner than this? This is a lot of fun. A lot of fun, isn't it? It's like saying, hey, I never knew I could think this way. I never knew I could say this. Can I really say that? Of course, say it. Say it. As I say, say it. Don't think you can say it. Say it. Prove to yourself you can say it. You won't do the light body shift until you prove to yourself you can say this stuff. Thinking that I can say it is not enough. Say it. Say, I am not guilty. I don't have any guilt. Guilt doesn't exist. Say, there is no such thing as guilt. Say, there is no such thing as guilt. Say, guilt doesn't exist. Say it. Guilt doesn't exist. Never has and never will. Plain and simple. It's nothing. The belief in it is nothing but a belief in a black hole. You know, that's all. Heavy density. Let's just keep making the density heavier and heavier and heavier. That's what a black hole is. It's like totally heavy density, right? Yeah, I mean, this is the direction of the reptilians, the Dracos, and their allies, and their cronies, and this whole cosmic corporate culture, the negative aspect of it, is they want us to go into this black hole. They follow us into the black hole. You won't be sorry. You will be blissful. Continuity fear will disappear. No, it won't. It'll still be follow us like our shadow. Continuity fear is like a shadow. It follows us everywhere. There's no black hole that'll ever get rid of it. That's not the way. So, there's so many, many, many singing that Pied Piper song. Don't listen to them. Don't listen to them anymore. Don't listen to them anymore. Don't give them the opportunity anymore. That's it. They've had enough time. Their time's up. They're gonna do whatever they're gonna do without me. And without you, right? Just say, hey, whatever you're going to do, you're going to do without me and my friends. You're going to have to do without us. That's it. You know, 27th, it's decision time. You know, there's no more talking now. There's no more back and forth. Decision time has already gone and passed. So we've decided we're going to light density. And you've decided, you know, others have decided they're going to heavy density. And so there's nothing to talk about. Nothing to talk about at this point. We just wish we don't have a nice density. But again, continuity feels like a shadow. You know, either we have to invite all our projections home and work at it until it's evaporated, and there's no other way. There's no other way. Plain and simple, there is no other way. Jesus will tell you a million times again, there is no other way. There is no other way. I am the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody comes to the God except through me, right? Except through the one truth, the one life, the one spirit. There's not two. Nobody comes to it through two-ness, only through the oneness. Only through the oneness. There is no guilt. There's only one truth. There is no two wills. There's only one will. There's no two authorities. There's only one authority. And I am that authority. Jesus was speaking from the standpoint of I am-ness. I am that authority. He didn't mean that his appearance is the only authority. He means I am is the only authority. Spirit is the only authority. Truth is the only authority. And since there's only one authority, we are it. We are it. That's all. It's very simple. We are it. We're all it. We're all the one family. And as far as, you know, Jesus taking all our sins upon him, he's talking from the standpoint of spirit. He's telling us, invite all your projections back home. And you can do it. He showed you can do this. Even death you can invite back home, which he did. And says resurrect and say, hey, it's fine. I'm fine now. See, no problem. I invited death back home. Death is no more. It's sitting quietly here. It's inert. It has no effect at all on me. And he says, you can do this too. You have to. Invite all your projections back home. The sins, quote, sins. Take them all upon spirit. Spirit can take all these sins back upon itself. Just like Jesus said, died for our sins. He took all our sins upon him. He was showing us what we have to do, is what Jesus was doing. He says, and you can do it. I did it. I can show you I did it. You can do it too. Invite all your projections back home. So he invited all our projections back home to him and saying, see, doesn't bother me the slightest bit. Still flawlessly, perfectly spirit, right? I mean, it's not that we don't have to do this. You know, we still have to do it because we're sovereigns of our own experiencing, just like Jesus is. But he showed us there's not a single one that cannot be invited back home, right? So there is this, you know, there's some truth to religion, that story, you know, there is some truth to this. You know, they've just got a little, you know, they're a little bit off. They don't quite, they've sort of made it suitable to the personality, you know, and thinking, oh, no, we don't have to call our projections home. You know, Jesus, whatever Jesus did, we don't have to do it. Well, we do have to do it. We do have to do it. He showed us that we can do it. There's not one that we cannot call home, all right, and that it will be still and inert once we call the projection home. There's no projection that has its own will. There is none. There is none. There is none. It's all our will. It's all our will. It's all our will. So Jesus' sayings are very, once you see the truth, they're very simple. So, oh, of course that's what he was saying. We just conflated it with the personality is the problem. Thinking that, well, it's not possible for us. So Jesus did it, but we can't do it. So we said, well, Jesus is different than us. So see, this is the heavy density folks tried to teach us this. And here they said, oh, yeah, Jesus did it because he's special. But you're not like that. There's only one of Jesus. So you're not that. And this is a lie. No, Jesus did it because he's spirit. And he said that we can do it because we're spirit. He says, you will do the same as I have done, for sure. Okay, there's no doubt about it. He's calling us all home. He's just calling us all home. He says, you know, I returned home, you can return, you will return home too. In fact, the Holy Spirit's already worked it all out for us. It's all done. It's all a done deal. We just have to get used to and accept it. So the continuity fear, we still have it. You know, Jesus can't get rid of that for us. We have to work on the continuity fear. We're afraid to realize, you know, that hey, I'm light. I never left home. I'm pure light. That's all I am. And so we work at it gradually. Jesus knows this. You know, all the great sages know it. So we work at it, but it's time to pick up the pace right now, which is we are doing that right now, right? We are doing that. The heavy density folks are feeling like they think they've got the upper hand, pulling out all the stops. Not all the stops, and we don't care what they do, whatever they care. We're not do whatever they can do, whatever they want. We're not paying attention anymore, anyway. So who cares what they do? Yeah. We're not paying attention. We're paying attention to, you know, the sages and the saints, lightening up. I am the light. I am the light. I am the light. Say I am the light. Say I am the light. Say I am the light. That's it. I am the light. I am the light. I literally am the light. That's all I am. There is no flesh. I am the light. There is no flesh. Now, this doesn't mean that, quote unquote, the flesh will disappear, because that means there is flesh, but it'll disappear. We're not saying that. We're saying there is no flesh. There's never been any flesh, actually. We're not making illusions true and then getting rid of them. This is, one of Jesus' key points and teachings. He says, the mistake we make, we're trying to make illusions true and then get rid of them. This is a mistake that religion has made, basically, one of them. And we're correcting that mistake here, okay? We're not condemning religion. We're saying that there are mistakes there that need to be corrected. So we don't say that, okay, the flesh is real, but we got rid of it. We say, I am the light. There is no flesh. There's never been any flesh. I am the light. There's never been any flesh. I've always been the light. I am the light. I've always been the light. There's never been any flesh at all, which is true. There's not a flesh body here. It's actually just all light. It's all just an image of light, an appearance of light. There is no flesh. There's no flesh anywhere. There's no world anywhere, actually, either. There's no world at all. There's no matter at all. There's no universe at all, actually. There's no universe whatsoever. It's all light. It's all the one true light. There is no other light. I am the one true light. There is no other light. There is no flesh. There's never been any flesh. So nothing has to happen to the flesh. We just realize there isn't any flesh. It's not like the flesh will disappear. It's not like our what we call our appearance or body is going to poof, go up spontaneous combustion and just vanish or something. No. Because then when we say, oh yeah, there was the flesh, but I got rid of it. No. We say, no, that this what you see as a body is just light. I just see it in a different way, different perspective now. So we'll keep appearing here. We won't disappear that way. We'll keep appearing here for now. You would think so, right? So it's not the fearful thing that we thought of. Oh my gosh, my body will just burn up, vanish. No, there is no body to burn up. There is no body to spontaneously combust. How can light spontaneously combust? It cannot. How can light disappear? It cannot. Now, at some point, we can lighten our density such that the appearance may shift a little bit, right? Sure. Some of the great sages have done that. Just when their time is up, like Adi Shankar, for instance, no one knows what happened to him. People say he just turned into light. I mean, just his body started glowing, turning lighter and lighter and lighter, and just, no longer saw the body. He just lightened up the density appearance of it. So it was... didn't appear to be a flesh body anymore, a heavy density body anymore. Jesus did that amount of ascension, right? Just started glowing a lot brighter and brighter, light, and just sort of vanished. Some of the others have done this, absolutely. It's not a big deal. I mean, ultimately, we'll do it too. Everyone will do this. In fact, it's already been done. Everyone's already done it. Keep that in mind. Everyone has already done it because the Holy Spirit is in charge of time. From the Holy Spirit's perspective, everyone has already set down time. It's already been done. We're just honoring, worshiping time. A lot of those who are worshiping time are going to heavier density. Those who are honoring time go to lighter density. So yeah, we're talking about this here. See, this is a cool thing here. It's like a campaign speech. I'm campaigning for lighter density, for light bodies, for lighter density. This is a campaign speech. Come on, everyone, Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Yes, we can do this. Yes, we can lighten the density. Not by atoning for guilt, but by realizing there's no such thing as guilt. Atoning for guilt is the false path. It's the false path that many are being led down this primrose path. Say, hey, guess what? Make right by me, make it all right, all the terrible things you did to me, make it right, and atone for your guilt, and then you will lighten up. So they think they're on this lighted path, atoning for guilt. No, they're not. they're on the heavy density path. It only seems to be light for a little while, but then it gets heavier and heavier and heavier. And a lot of people are waking up and say, hey, wait a minute. This whole atoning for guilt thing that we thought, you know, we're going to go along with someone who's projecting this notion that, hey, you know, you folks, you're full of terrible guilt, guilt of every kind, you know, you name it, right? But under my leadership, you will be able to atone for all that guilt, and we'll make sure that you make the right the wrongs that, you know, all you did. And once you do that, you're going to find yourself in heaven. You know, it'll be great. So a lot of people got fooled by that. And fortunately, I did not, thanks to all these great sages and teachers, and especially Jesus that you know, is helping out. And they're now saying, having buyer regrets, say, wait a minute. You know, this seems like a trick, a trap, because it's never ending, is it? Is it? It's never ending. They want more. Because it doesn't get rid of the continuity fear. So they say, well, we need to go deeper. We need to go deeper into guilt, deeper into darkness, you know. We know what the answer's there, we're just not deep enough in darkness. And fear and guilt, and all, you know, go deeper, and this continuity fear is still there. And they say, well, we got to go deeper still. And people start, at some point, they start saying, I'm kind of scared. I don't think I want to keep going down there. Help. And then he called the Holy Spirit, help. You know, help, Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit says, don't worry. It's already done. You're already free. You just gradually get used to this. I'll help you get used to it. You're already saved. Already safe. So the religious people have it, you know, kind of half right, you know. They keep trying to think, well, there's two wills, you know. How do we, you know, like this diaphysitism, or what is that? The hypostatic union of the two divine natures. You know, there's two natures, human and divine, and they can't figure out, you know, exactly. So they're trying to. They don't realize the real clarity of Jesus' teaching yet. But the rhetoric is at least partly true that they use. Like, we're all saved, you know. Just accept Jesus and you're saved. The rhetoric is got a ring of truth to it, right? But their actions belie, you know, the rhetoric. You know, the actions and the rhetoric don't line up, right? They don't line up. Sure, believe what Jesus told us, that we're all saved, and this will help us evaporate our continuity fear. Because it's true. Everyone has been already freed of our pretension of time, and we've all been freed from it, our continuity fear. Holy Spirit's already done it. So accept this, that everyone's already saved. In other words, accept what Jesus has told us, and we'll realize everyone's already saved, and this will really help us with our continuity fear. We'll go to lighter density. They're a bit muddled, you know. The religious message is a bit muddled in this world, and we really can't afford to be muddled at this point. Really cannot. So I'm not trying to put, you know, new wine in old wineskins. I'm not condemning religion by any means. I've been a big supporter of it, but it's a bit muddled. You know, it's a mixed message that they're putting out there, and it's not working. This is why I've been sounding the alarm. Say, look, you know, you got to do better. The religious leaders of the world are teaching a mixed message, and if you're believing a mixed message, these Dracos and their cronies, these heavy density demons, are going to pull you down. They're going to pull you down. They'll be able to pull you down. You know, it has to be very cut and dried. And that's why Jesus came in 1965, October 21st, 1965, to Helen Schuckman, Columbia University, New York, New York. Which is why I'm backing the Mets in the World Series, because something good came out of New York. Really, something great came out of New York. You know, a lot of people I talk to want the Royals to win Kansas City because they hate New York. I hate everything in New York. New York's terrible. New York. No, it's not. It's not terrible. A Course in Miracles came out of New York. Come on. There's something redeeming, very redeeming, that came out of New York. And the Mets aren't bad people. Come on. There's some very lovable characters there with the Mets. Why does everybody hate the Mets? There's a lot of good people in New York, really. A lot of bad ones too. There's a lot of polarity in New York. There's a lot of New York's really into heavy density, and some of New York may be into lighter density. Okay, all right. It is possible. Yes, it is. Let's not scapegoat New York. I can't hate. How can I hate New York? A Course in Miracles came from New York. Come on. William Thetford and Helen Schuckman, William Thetford and the others came from New York. For God's sakes. Lighten up on New York. Yeah, everybody has such a negative opinion. I went to New York. I hated New York. I hated it. I was in New York in 1967. Yeah. Went to World's Fair in Montreal. And then went to New York. And so I walked the streets of New York. I said, I have. I've seen the Empire State Building. I've seen all, you know, I've seen New York. Pan Am Building. I mean, all these skyscrapers. It's like, oh my gosh. In New York, 1967, I was walking the streets of New York as a kid. How old was I? I was 11 years old. And it's like, wow. An intense place. Very intense place, isn't it? It got nearly nasty in New York, didn't it? Really nasty. And Rudy Giuliani came in and cleaned it up. He did a great job cleaning up New York. I don't know how it is now. But yeah, I mean, yeah, New York is a bastion of liberalism and all this kind of stuff, and which is, you know, mixed message, ism, to say the least. But again, A Course in Miracles came from New York, and Jesus started that, this, you know, his second advent, his return in New York, you know, which was the center of the psychoanalytic world at that time. It was the center of the highbrow intellectual center of the world. So he said, hey folks, you know, you need to do a little bit better. Come on. He says, you're doing good, but you need to do better. You know, he was very laudatory of them. You know, that's the way he is. He said, hey, you're doing great work, but take a look at this. This is better. And so a lot of people did in New York, did take a look at it. And a lot of people in California, Bay Area also. Those are the two highbrow centers of the world, really. Two of the most highbrow centers in the world, for sure. Bay Area and New York. So they took a look. They said, hey, let's spend our time considering this. Let's give our consideration to this. This, it's only fair that we do so, because this is presenting, you know, seems to be a more enlightened viewpoint. So this black and white clear clarity, you know, it's just cut and dry. It went one way, darkness, heavy density, you know, darkness, black wholeness. Jesus says that doesn't work. Won't work for you. Won't get rid of continuity fear for you at all. It'll still be with you like a shadow in the way of working, practicing. As he says, practice on getting on the wow, get used to this. Wow, I am the light. I am the light. I am not a body. I am free. I'm still spirit exactly as God created me. Practice. He said, this will evaporate your continuity fear, and this works. This will work for you. This is what works. So, it's very cut and dried, isn't it? One way doesn't work. One way works. There isn't any other way. There's not some way that both works and doesn't work. There isn't any such way like that. Now, we've been dilettantes, you know, pretty much for a long time. Say, yeah, Jesus, okay, we'll go your way. But we've been dilettantes at it, because kind of continuity fears had us, you know, tiptoeing through the tulips with Tiny Tim saying, hey, I don't know. I want to go really slow here and careful. That's understandable. But he said it's time to pick up the pace. Time to pick up the pace now, because, you know, the other side is picking up the pace. The heavy density folks, the heavy density demons are picking up the pace. And they're gonna hit you with a big old stink bomb, you know, very soon. It says, you know, come on down into darkness. We go, look what we got for you. You get, make atonement for all your hideous guilt, all the terrible, rotten things you've done for us. But we have a way for you to atone. Just come down here and we'll torture you for forever, and you know, that'll work. And Jesus says, no, don't fall for this. This is a lie. This is the lie of Satan. This is deceit. Don't fall for this. So my only hope is that, you know, somehow I'm able to reach more in this world. I'm not reaching very many right now, which is it's a shame. It is the way it is. Maybe I'm not ready to reach more. That's fine, because this message is so intense. Maybe there's a lot of people, I wouldn't say it. You know, I just feel that those who are watching the videos now are the very intense ones that really are hanging with it. You know, and they're receptive to this. And so I can speak this way. If there was if I had thousands of people, you know, viewing every video, I might water down the message because they're all wishy-washy. Say, don't go so fast. I can't handle it. Please slow down. But we can't slow down right now. You know, it's all or nothing right now. It's black or white. It's false path or true path right now. It's heavier density or lighter density. You know, it's cut and dried. It's that simple. We're either going to fish or keep cutting bait. You know, it's time to fish. Time to go to light densities, very light densities, and enjoy that for a while. So this, you know, core group of those who are still watching the videos, I feel I can say the truth here and speak up like this and get used to speaking up like this. It's not so easy to speak like this in culture and society, is it? No, are you kidding? They'll go after you like they would, you know, they'll go after, like they went after Trump. They went after him and tried to destroy him. Well, you know, they go after, they, you know, I feel they go after me like a million times more because I'm, you know, really bringing the truth here. And that's just like, wow. He said, we can't have that. We can't have that. You know, they lock this guy up in an insane asylum. And I say, it's too late for that. You know, too late. I'm not even entertaining your notions, silly notions anymore. So, you know, we'll see how it goes. We'll see how it goes. You know, we see you speak up. You know, they throw the whole kibosh at you, kibosh and caboodle, as we used to say. Try to give you the heebie-jeebies, as we used to say. The kitten caboodle, throw the kitten caboodle, the whole kibosh, the kitten caboodle. Try to give you the heebie-jeebies. It's all true. It's true then, it's true now, right? However you want to say it, it's the same truth. You know, you're fired. You know, you're fired from everything. Say, well, not so fast. You can't fire me. I'm the only authority there is. So you can't fire me from myself. I am the one true authority on myself. There is no other. Okay. I say that I am the one true authority of myself, and there is no other. I am the true self-authority, and there is no other. I am the authority of myself, and there is no other authority whatsoever, none. So, whatever you do, don't give up now. You know, now you've already decided, you just say, okay, let the wow, it's going to calm down here, and just, yeah, I can do this, I can start jogging, as it were, I can pick up the pace a little bit, let the Holy Spirit trick you into it, so, you know, it's a benign trick, you know, oh my gosh, I got to start running, hey, I can do it. Maybe you'll have some incident that'll shake you up, but you can handle it, you realize, hey, I can do this. I don't have to keep listening to these folks. See, like I said, it doesn't matter. The next president really doesn't matter ultimately because we won't even be here in terms of flesh. We'll be light. We're light right now, but we'll know that we're light. See, there's a difference. We're already light. Everyone's already light, but we will know that we're light. And we won't be pretending that we're not anymore, so we can start dropping the pretense. So it doesn't really matter wherever which way the world seems to go. As it sinks down heavier density, who cares? We're not going to be there. So whoever's the leader there in the heavy density doesn't make a hill of beans. I care less about it. The leader of dense heavy density. Well, what does that have to do with us? Nothing. Oh, let the Holy Spirit worry about that. It's already solved it all. So put that on the Holy Spirit. So certainly don't get in any antagonistic activity with anybody at all or something. Just say, I, I, I refuse to be intimidated. I refuse to entertain this insanity. You know, I've already decided. I'm an excited voter. I've already decided. So it's no, you're wasting your time on me. I've already decided. I don't need to tell you what I've decided, because you're not the authority in my life. I am. I'm the sole authority in my life. I don't need to explain anything to you. You know, what you decide is your preference. I'm fine with that. Whatever you decide, I know you're in perfect standing with God, and nothing can ever change that. And you're already, all your continuity fear has already been, you've already been freed from it by the Holy Spirit. So, you know, I don't have any guilt. I need to get more and more and more and more this way. You know, I know it's not easy, but I have to keep practicing. I have to keep hearing it. Hey, somebody's saying this. Maybe I can do this too. You know, it's like that. Look at this fiberglass. This stupid. I'm being very stupid right now in terms of worldly details, you know, because I'm in such a just go for it mode that, you know, I said, why did I rush it and put my arms all in this, you know, fiberglass insulation? And now I've got all these itches. I can't get it out of there. It takes a while. Really does. It's and stupid, you know, stupid. I was just in too much of a rush. Everyone's in a rush right now. I'm getting push to go faster. You know, the rush by the world. Heavy density people are pushing me too. Hey, you know, you got to get with this program. And so, you know, it's not easy. I know it's not easy for any of us right now, is it? But I think I know it's going to get easier right now. It's going to get easier because I'm able to speak up like this. And speaking up like this is what's required to help out. And we can help even more. More help is coming. It's on the way. Just hold on a little longer. Help is on the way. Brighter day is coming for those who hope, those who believe and pray. Don't let go. You won't have tomorrow if you, you know, give up today. So hold on just a little longer. Help us on the way. Wow. Somehow I just got an hour passed and I wasn't even aware of it. How's that possible? It's just 38 minutes. I look again. It's a minute and 26. An hour and 26. Wow. Must be butter, because I'm on a roll, that is for sure. We want to be on a roll. We want to get on a roll. We want to know it's possible to get on a roll here. You know, you see that it's possible. People started waking up, you know, saw Trump. They said, hey, you know, what's this? Somebody's not intimidated of speaking their mind, you know, speaking how they really feel directly. So we say, hey, maybe we can start speaking how we feel. Now, what we need to do is ultimately get with the saints and the sages and say, hey, we can say the spiritual stuff. You know, it's not just political stuff. We can say spiritual stuff. You know, politicians have to be careful. They're trying to get elected. But we're not trying to get elected to anything. We've elected ourselves to lighten up, go to lighter densities. We're the sole candidate in our election. And we're the sole vote. Actually, there's one vote, one candidate, one vote, and I'm it. There's one vote, one candidate, and I am it. Say that. One vote, one candidate, and I am it. Say that. There's one vote, there's one candidate, and I am it. Do the lighten up. Let the ones that are doing the tighten up do the tighten up. We'll do the lighten up. Hey, everybody, I'm all see Drell and the bells. All seeing, but all see Drell. All see heaven and the bells. I'm all see, hey, everybody, we're all see heaven and the bells. And we're going to do the lighten up. And we're from heaven. Hey everybody, I'll see heaven and the bells, and we're from the vision of oneness. We're from non-dual reality, and we're gonna do the lighten up. Oh hey, we're all see clearly in the bells, and we're from heaven, and we're gonna do the lighten up. we're from the light, and we're gonna do the lighting up. We're from truth. We're from Truthsville, Arizona. We're gonna do the lighting up. Hey, everybody. We're all see clear and the bells, and we're from Truthsville, Arizona, and we're gonna do the lighting up. Let's everybody do the lighting up with us here. Yeah. Although we do a different something, that's too robotic. Right. All see clear here, I'm all see clear here. And the bells, we're from Truthsville, Arizona. And we're all gonna do the lighting up. Yeah. Everything is Somethingsville, Arizona. That came from the rise and fall of Reginald Perrin. Maybe the last comedy show I ever watched. I think I stopped watching comedy after that because it was not as good. Forget it. Rise and Fall of Reginald Perrin was quite funny. You know, sort of poking fun at business and the obeisance to, you know, groupthink, corporate think. You know, it really skewered corporate world, corporate business. It just showed how crazy it all is. You know, it just. And so one of the guys always said there, yeah, Truthsville, Arizona, that's Wrightsville, Arizona, Reg. Everything is Somethingville, Arizona. Reggie, I don't like what you're doing, Reggie. Yes, CJ, of course, CJ. I didn't get to where I got to be today, Reggie, by being a yes man, Reggie. Oh, yes, CJ. Yeah, I understand, CJ, yes, CJ. You're not a yes man, are you, Reggie? No, CJ, I'm not a yes man. No, yes, CJ, I'm not a yes man. Goodbye, Reggie. I did have a good laugh at that. So we're from Truthsville, Arizona, y'all. Yeah, we're going to Truthsville, Arizona. That's where we're going. Where you headed to, son? I'm going headed to Truthsville, Arizona, sir. Well, that's a mighty fine place, son. Good luck on your journey. I know you're going to get there. Yes, we will. Thank you very much. God bless and Godspeed. Yes, sir. Going to Truthsville, Arizona, everybody. Banjo on my knee. Going to Truthsville, Arizona. Truthsville, Arizona. Here I come. Got some really clear saints there, and I'm going to sit with one. Borrowing from Kansas. It's on Kansas City. Yeah, we're not the flesh. We're like, there is no flesh. There is no flesh. There's only the light. There is no electromagnetism, there's only the light, actually. It's only the light pretending not to be the light, but there is no electromagnetic universe at all, actually. There's only the light. It's only the light, there's only the light, there's only the light. Everything is already released in the light. There's no time to the light, it's always right now. All light is right now. All light is light, all light is right now. Say, all light is light, all light is right now. Say, all light is light, all light is right now. Say, all light is light, all right, light is right now. There's no light that is not light right now. All light is all light right now. All light is all light right now, and all now is right now. I'm going to take a vacation to Truthsville, Arizona. Boy, howdy, that is where I'm headed right now. Truthsville, Arizona. Lightsville, Arizona. Ascensionville, Arizona. I got a house waiting for me in Ascensionville, Arizona. Whoa, two little spiders are, well, they're both double right here, right by my face. These two spiders are hanging in the air right now, too. Wow. What's going on? They're in tandem right now, huh? Maybe this is one is going down, one's going up. Let's see what happens. Wow. I didn't even notice. This is really something. Hello, okay. Which one's gonna go up? One's gonna go down? What's gonna go on here? Take a look at this and see how this plays out. Itsy bitsy spider. Dun da dun da da. Right? A couple of itsy bitsy spiders here. One's venturing over in the middle of the computer right now. It's right here. Oh, there's three of them. There's three of them now. Wow. I saw a third. There's three of them. What is going on? One of them has just touched down on the computer right here. As a matter, no, it actually it affixed a little web here to the computer, and now it's climbing its web going up this way. So okay, it's headed to Ascensionville, Arizona. This little spider. It says, "Hey, I made it." Wow, that's really something, I guess. It's time for them. Okay, so this one is now headed back, and it's like the sausage race, Milwaukee County Stadium, and the kielbasa is ahead of the bratwurst, and the Polish sausage is coming on strong. Here comes the German sausage, and it's the bratwurst that crosses first. So this one is going back up. Interesting. Wow, it's amazing. They're like just hanging right in the air. It's like they're just floating, like nothing. Lighter density, huh? These spiders have a very light density. My gosh, quite extraordinary. The light density of them. They look like transparent almost. Really, I mean, the light shining through them, they're like transparent. Take a close look at this one. It's like you can't hardly tell there's a body there at all. I do see the little tiny webs now. Oh yeah, they're bringing down webs. But yeah, their bodies are virtually transparent. Pretty awesome, huh? I don't know what they're trying to catch here. I mean, they're not swinging, not enough web here to catch anything. This one might be affixed to me, as a matter of fact. And this other one has already gone up to higher density. I mean, lighter density up here. It's already gone back up there. And this one is attached to me, I think. I have to. Where is it attached? I see, it seems to be. I don't know. As I move, it moves. Maybe it's. I don't know. Where are you attached? It's attached somewhere. It's attached to my hand somehow. What's going on? Now it's attached to this hand. Now this one's come down. Oh my gosh, I broke the web. Sorry. Go back up here. Okay, go back up there. And you, I don't know what you're attached to here. It's attached to something. Oh yeah, see, I'm bringing it back up. And brought it back home. So it was attached to my hands. That is really something. And they're all three are now back home. The first one climbed up like that itself, and the other ones I brought back home. Great. They're probably wondering, wow, what in the heck happened? They were using me as an anchor point. That's funny. Didn't even know it. The filaments are so light you can't even feel them. You can't see. Yeah, it's extraordinary. Extraordinary, funny little play right there, huh? Oh my gosh. See, everything's a play, isn't it? So to speak, they call that a play. Oh, speaking of that, I was sitting at a stoplight today and I suddenly said, hey, you know what? Everything is just grace. It's just a play of grace, and you can see it that way. And it's true, it all is. I saw a moment I kind of saw that. I accepted it. Because so much stuff's been happening to me every now that it's just like I say, hey, this is just all a play of grace, everything. And from the Holy Spirit standpoint, it is. It is just a play of grace on the Holy Spirit standpoint. Now, from not the Holy Spirit standpoint, from the personality, from our standpoint of trying to deceive God and trying to get rid of continuity fear in the wrong way, it's hell. It's hell. It doesn't seem, you know. But the Holy Spirit is grace is everywhere. And just minutely, bit by bit by bit by bit, you know, we respond to this grace. It permeates everything, actually. But if we choose to ignore it and overlook it, it doesn't seem as though it's happening or it's there at all. But it's present. It is. I can see that this entire play of grace, the Holy Spirit's play of grace. That doesn't mean I'm agreeing with the idea that all this is God's play in terms of God's playing hide and seek with. No, that's not true. This is an oversimplification. This is a mixed message. It's not true. We're trying to fool God, okay, and we're trying to separate from God, and that's not really a play. That's an effort, a willful effort to change our will. That you can't call that some game that God's playing with God with itself. Then no. God didn't say, hey, you know, this is the game I want to play. God said, Spirit's free to play anything, do anything it wants to. Didn't choose for us to play this game. We decided to. So, but then the Holy Spirit is playing this grace. This play of grace. Always, the option is there. The potentiality is there, and always, everywhere. But we choose to go kind of slowly, you know, and densely, you know. So we see a little here, a little here, a little here, a little here. But I can see as possible that everything is actually totally in grace, in the Holy Spirit's grace. It is. It's already worked it all out. So you could say, since it's already saved everything, saved us all from this self-delusion pretense, everything is a play of the Holy Spirit's grace then. We could say this is true. And then from that standpoint, everything becomes, you know, wonderful. You're in sync with that play. Wow. Everything is great. Everything is love. Everything is good here. Seeing it from that perspective. That would be a great perspective to see it from. So I took a glimpse of that and accepted and say, okay, yeah, I can see that, how that would be. Let it be. Let it be. Let us experience this. It's all a play of grace. I know it's all a play of grace. Say, I know it's all a play of grace, the Holy Spirit's grace. I know that this is all now a play of the Holy Spirit's grace. I know this is all just a play of the Holy Spirit's grace. Yeah, those little spiders have not parachuted down. They're trying to think about this one. They're going through a full stop in the wow experience right now themselves, actually, is wow, what happened? That really happened? They went totally green. Oh, here comes one. Okay. Start say, okay, time to wanna go back on, go back down. No, it's going back up, just floated a filament. That's what they do. They float filaments and let the breeze take it where it would go. And they rely on the wind, really. The filaments are so light that the slightest breeze, you can't feel it, is enough to cause the filament to go somewhere, and then when it hits something, it's sticky and it sticks there, and that's how then the spider's able to go down there, and then from there it'll go back up, it fixes it stronger, and then it goes back up, and then it drops another filament, you know, it just keeps working on it and is able to do things that way. Pretty extraordinary. We've had some big web spinners around here recently, huge, spinning massive webs. Wow, very impressive. How in the world do they do that? Oh, there's another one that's working on it, so okay. I mean, those webs are stretched out over like 10 feet or so, you know, almost. I mean, as far as the lines, connecting lines, the web itself might be, you know, 2 feet wide, big. But the line, the anchoring lines go far away, you know. One's anchored on the real high, one's down by the ground, one's 8 feet high, one's on the ground. I mean, they're really very impressive what they do. Anyway. some people say, don't talk about spiders, you know, please, please, please. Yeah, okay. These little itsy bitsy ones, though, they're so transparent, they're not bothersome. I saw them right by my face, and I said, oh, hello, you know, it's no big deal. They're lighter density, right? It sort of represents lighter density, doesn't it? See, there, it's not so scary. Fear is not so scary. Spiders sort of represent, you know, our density fear. And the big, hairy, dark spiders, like, ah, I don't like dark density. I hate it. I remember I used to hate those big, dark spiders. I still do. Don't like them. Well, I'm not scared anymore, but I just say, hey, you know, I prefer not to hang around with you. And these little white, little ones that are like transparent to the light, just like it see, there's hardly any form there at all to them. They seem like ephemeral, you know. These symbolize like light bodies, as it were. So, yeah, I was like, oh, it's not so scary. Not so scary, no. That guy with the lizard, I just, you know, didn't entertain him at all. He was right there. There was looking at me. I think he was trying to say, hey, 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 I need to hook this guy. I just, you know, just looked away and didn't pay attention. Take care of my own business, and then I said I need to go find something in the store, and left. You know, I just left. I didn't have to entertain him. I don't have to get any conversation. One vote, one candidate, one vote. That's it. That's me. That's what I am. One vote, one candidate. I am the candidate. I'm the only candidate there is. I'm the only vote there is. And I vote for light. Light body, light density. So shall it be. So shall it be. When I is single, our whole body be full of light. When one will, one candidate, one vote, you know, one authority, one truth. When we affirm that and accept it, then we'll realize we are light. And we can move mountains. He says, literally, you can tell the mountain to move, and it will happily move for you. No problem at all. But you can't have a split, believe in a split will to do this. You can't have all these projections thinking that they have some separate will. You can't do those things. Jesus says, you can do all these miracles and more, greater than the ones you've seen me do. There's nothing that the universe won't gladly do for you. Not the universe, you mean the light. Nothing that the light will not gladly do for us. Be thrilled. That's what its purpose is. We just have to tell it to do so without believing in a split will. That there's some split will means there's something we need to do first. We need to get rid of the other will. There's some dynamic. We have to win a contest or something. You cannot function that way. That's not how we're created to function at all. You can't do the miracles that Jesus did if we're, you know, believing in a split will like that. It's impossible. So we say, well, I can't do them. Well, because we say, well, the personality's not agreeing. First, I got to get the personality to agree with me. No. There is no personality, has no will at all. It's nothing. There's no self there. There's no will. There's no authority at all. Zero. So why do we need to get it to agree with us? We don't. Just call it back home. How are we doing here? 147. These spiders are spelunky. You know, they're going down in the abyss. And say, oh, I don't like the abyss so much. I'm going back up now. Time to go up. This one's going up into the light. Go, 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 go into the light. Go into the light. Yep, that's where it's going, all right. So wouldn't it be wonderful if everybody could hear this and listen to this and be inspired, you know? It'd be great. Just to say, hey, I can hear this. A lot of, like when Trump first started, people say, you can't say that. I mean, everybody, all the pundits said, oh, you know, after his first speech, you know, say, I'm running for president. They say, oh, he's finished. He's finished. What an idiot. He's completely imploded. He won't even have a second day. This is it. And then when he lasted a week, they said, this is amazing. He lasted a week, but it's finished now. Definitely finished. It's over with. That's what they all are saying, right? Then, you know, he kept talking. They said, oh, well, this guy's, you know, obviously he won't last another day. How dare he stand up to, you know, such and such, these these spin doctors and doctresses of heavy density. How dare he stand up to them? Someone's in a little black cocktail dress. How dare he stand up to that black cocktail dress? He's finished. He's finished. He'll implode. No one will support him now. Guess what? Didn't happen the way the pundit said, did it? The pundits absolutely buried him. And they keep trying to bury him. I don't know what's going on. I haven't paid attention since August 29th. I don't know what's happening. But, they try to bury these people. They say, they got no chance. Impossible. They're finished. Everyone's going to abandon them. And when they don't, the pundits are they need psychotherapy or something. They're on drugs. I'm sure they're all taking heavy doses of drugs of some sort now, just because their minds have been blown. There's too much wow, and they're not used to, they don't know the full stop in the wow. So, they're thinking too much about it, which they're not supposed to do. They're not forgiving themselves for using a false premise for their logic. So, I'm sure they're gobbling a lot of, anti-freakout drugs. Because they're freaking out. This just can't happen. Not well, I'm a pundit, my punditism is being pummeled. It's being pulverized. I don't want my punditism to be pulverized. I didn't get to where I got to be today by having my punditism pulverized. And Trump starts to speak, "Goodbye, Donald." And he says, "I haven't left yet, actually, CJ. I'm still talking." "Goodbye." He says, "Well, I'm still here. I'm still talking." "I didn't get to where I got to be today by letting you talk to me like that." But he says, "Well, it's a new era right now, and I'm still talking." "But this is pulverizing my punditude." "I've got this punditude to protect, and you're pulverizing it." Says, enjoy it. This is what it is. Just enjoy it. Maybe you can change your mind. Time to change your mind, CJ. "I didn't get to where I got to be today by changing my mind, Mr. Trump." He says, time to change your ways then, isn't it? He said, "I didn't get to where I got to be today by having you tell me that." "Well, you didn't get to where you got to be today by telling me to leave, did I?" "Does not compute. I am the IBM 5150 personal computer. I was created by engineers at IBM. I am the IBM 5150 computer. I was created by engineers by IBM. I am told that I am very nice and lovable and very intelligent too. I am the IBM 5150 personal computer. I was engineered by engineers. IBM, they told me I am the IBM 5150. They told me nice the silence, huh? Kind of nice the silence. Yeah, absolutely. Inner silence here. We can handle that, can't we? We can handle that. We can handle the silence, right? Not a problem. Not a problem. All the programs go kaplooey. Kaplooey, and we can handle the silence. The silence. The science of silence. We can handle that silent science. The science of silence. We can handle that new science. It's a new science. Science. It's a new science. Silence. Silence is the new science. Say that. Silence is the new science. Silence is the new silence. Silence is the new science. Silence is the new silence. Silence is the new science. Science is... Silence is a new science. Silence is a new science. Silence is a new science. Silence is the new silence. Is the new silence. Silence is the new science. Get with the new science. Silence is the new math. Get with the new math. Come on. Silence is the new fashion. Get with the new fashion. Get with silence. Call all our projections home, and there's silence. We can still talk, but there's still silence. Speaking of heavier density, the traffic here is insane. And then I look at this apartment buildings. I saw this gigantic apartment complex they're building right in the heart of Gridlockville. And it's just like, what? I mean, how many thousands of people are you going to cram in there? Probably starting at $3,000 for a one-room apartment, one-bedroom apartment. Granny and grandpa will be in there, and you know, nephews and nieces, cousins will be in there. I mean, the party were to turn around. This is what they do now. Not supposed to. They do. They stuff their apartments. How else can you afford $3,000 a month rent? And they all have cars, okay? So you can unleash tens of thousands of cars. You know, it's just crazy what they're doing. It's already out of control. And the building is still completely out of control. Any spot they can find, let's throw up a super high density apartment complex here. Yeah, we'll only make it 5 stories, you know, but we'll make a couple thousand units. Everybody here, there's no public transportation. Everybody has to drive. This is insane. It's not like Europe, you know, where everybody takes the train, or you know, New York, the subway or taxi. No. There's no, everybody has to drive here. It's crazy. And so, such big distances here, such big distances, wow. There you go, heavy, high density. Everything's going heavier, heavier density, heavier density, heavier density. Do the lighten up. So yeah, I'm not too much into eating right now, actually. Haven't eaten much today. I just like, but I came home, ate some broccoli and cauliflower and carrots. Veggies. But I'm starting to feel the hunger right now. It's starting to hit. That's good. That's a good thing. What are you doing? I'm studying the new science. What's the new science? Silence. Silence is the new science. Silence is the new science. So I'm doing my, you know, I'm doing core curriculum here. Right? Nobody left behind. I'm doing the new science. You gotta get with the new science. The old science, you know, that's passé. Really very passé. very heavy, very dense. Is that good? Not a good science. We're with the new science. This is really all inclusive, holistic, totally green. It's the total new green, the new green, totally green science. Silence. Hey kids, have you done your silence homework today? No, not yet. Okay. No watching television. You gotta do your science homework today. Okay. Okay, Mom. I'll help you out here. We'll all just sit in silence together. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. No. All silent lives matter. All silent lives matter. There is no guilt. All silent lives matter. Silence matters. Silence matters, okay? The new science, the new green science. This is the new silence, is the new green science. Heard it here first. Silence is the new green. Silence is the new green science. Silence is the new green science. Yep. Silence is the new green science. Silence is the new green revolution. Silence is how you go green. Hello, Holy Spirit. Yeah. Silence is the next big thing. Right here in Silicon Valley, all the next big things come out of Silicon Valley. Well, guess what? Silence is the next big thing coming out of Silicon Valley here. Silence is the next big thing. Even the computer agreed with us, went silent, right? Calling our projections home. Call all our technology projections home so they can all be silent. That's right. Silence is the new, is the true green revolution. Silence is the true green revolution. Go green, go silent. I'm going so eco-friendly, I'm not even eating. How about that?
Right?
Eating silence, you know? Silence is the new food. It's the new diet. Silence is the new diet. How are you doing? I'm dieting. How are you dieting? Silence is the new diet. Seeing all as light is the new environmental movement. This is the new environmental movement. Go silent, see all as light. Go green, go silent, go green. Plain and simple. We don't want to miss the boat. Those other folks are missing the boat. You know, they'd be struggling with heavy density, you know. It's so heavy, you know, I could hardly lift it. Oh, man. Well, they didn't go green enough, did they? So we're going green. We're going really green. We're going silent green. Go silent green. There's a nice slogan, isn't it? Go silent green. Go silent green. Say it. Go silent green. Go silent green. Go silent green. Go silent green. Say go silent green. Say go silent green. Say go silent green. I'm going silent green. Spider, I don't know, maybe. Oh, there's two of them up there. I don't know. Hanging out. What are you doing, spiders? Just hanging out. Once you stop eating so much, you don't even know what to eat anymore.
It's like that.
I don't want to eat. What am I going to go eat? Maybe some more broccoli? What am I going to eat? I don't know. Get out of the habit of eating and you just, it's weird. It's breakfast. What am I having for breakfast? I don't know. What did I have yesterday? What kind of creatures of habit say, okay, what I had yesterday? I had a kale smoothie. Oh, okay, I think I'll have a kale smoothie today. I said, wait a minute, what if I don't want a kale smoothie? What I had the day before? A kale smoothie, I don't know. It's so, you go in habit. You go in habit. So you break the habits of eating a bunch of food, and then you start just referring back, like a day back, a week ago. You don't really go back further than that. Your memory, sort of short-term memory, sort of locks us into what did you do recently. So what did I have dinner last night? Hardly anything. Oh, okay, I'll have hardly anything again. I'll have one order of hardly anything. Hold the fries. Yeah, probably just eat some more vegetables. It's a little bit of rice. Some mixed types of rice. A little mixed rice, little veggies. I don't know, maybe some lettuce. Call it good. You would think my weight was plummeting, but it's not. It's just stayed at 187 for the last 3 or 4 days. But it may take a drop tomorrow. I may see a 186 tomorrow. This is what I want to see. 186 tomorrow. That's good motivation. Got to see that 186. For 4 days now, it's like 187.0. No 186. It won't go there. I said, come on. What do I got to do? So, 186 tomorrow. Looking for that. So we get a good spiritual buzz going, and you just have to let the buzz keep going. We just keep getting used to it. Say, hey, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay to lighten up. This is all about lightening up. We're lightening up here. We're lightening up. And you got to let those who are doing it, let them do it, and don't bring those into the picture who are not doing it, because then that'll confuse things. It'll confuse things. So, hey, what are you doing? I don't understand. Explain what you're doing. But no, I can't spend my time entertaining those who are not lightening up, and they're all confused, because then that won't lighten up. There's a mood. There's a way to do it. You have to be light about stuff. You can't get into some heavy argument. That's not lightening up. It's not lightening up. Now, people used to use drugs to try to do it. Hey, man, I'm so stoned, I can't talk to you now, man. I don't understand what you're saying, man. Just leave me alone right now. Hey, Leo. So, but you cannot entertain this heavy, heavy argument back and forthness. That's not light. That's heavy. Lightness enjoys this lightness. It's light because it's right. It's light because it's right. It's light because it's right. So just share this. I'm just sharing. It's light because it's right. Just say it. It's light because it's right. That's light because it's right. It's not like heavy density can be light. It's not. It's not lightening, it's heavy density. It is what it is. It's heavy density. It's trying to get rid of light. So you can't try to get rid of light and at the same time feel that you're lightening up. It doesn't work that way. Can't have your cake and eat it too. Cannot. So we just have to, say, this is what we're doing. We're lightening up here. We're lightening up. Everyone's lightening up. Go silent green. We're all going silent green here. I'm going silent green. We can do that. Say, hey, what are you against going green? Come on. Look, go silent green. Someone tries to get an argument. Says, "Hey, I'm doing this new thing. It's a new science called silence, and it's the green, new green revolution. I'm going silent green. So, go silent green. I'm going silent green. It's not eco-friendly to be, arguing and going heavy is not being eco-friendly at all. It's being, That's the old, you know, burnout mode here. We don't want to burn out the planet, do we? Come on. Go silent green. They say, well, how is it doing this? Shh, that's the old science. The old science is off lot. Forget it. The new science is silence. Go silent green. That's the new science. You just have to do it. Doing it is the new science. That is the new style, the new culture is just doing it. Going silent is doing it. Do it. Now, it's not an endurance contest or anything. It's just an attitude. Go light, go silent, go light, go green. Go silent, go light, go green. Okay, how are these spiders doing? Are they putting lines out here or what? Probably, I don't know, lining things up. Lining up the light bodies. Okay. Go silent, go green. Go silent, go green. Go silent, go green. Go silent, save the world. Go silent, save the whales. Go silent and save the gray flocked ant moth. Are the North Bay wetlands reed hopping mite, you know? Save it. Go silent and save the planet. Go silent, save the planet. Go silent, save the planet. Go silent, save the planet. This is the new green revolution. Silence is the new green revolution. Be there or be nowhere. And it's not a heavy silence. We're not talking about a heavy silence. How about a light silence? How about a very light silence? How about seeing that silence is very light? There's no conflict in it. There's no heaviness in it, right? It's very light, like spaciousness. It's very light. How heavy is pure spaciousness? Is it heavy or is it light? It's light. Completely light, isn't it? There's nothing weighing it down. Nothing ever weighs it down. Absolute silence. Go silent. Go light.
Some people might say, you know, hey, I didn't get to where I got to be today by being silent.
Yeah, but you're ruining the planet, man. You want to keep ruining the planet? You're going to destroy us all, you know?
I didn't get to where I got to be.
Maybe I can get Bill Clinton to be silent, you know, and start the Silent Foundation. And go around collecting funds for the Silent Foundation. Save the planet. Just be silent. Just be silent. We'll call him Silent Bill. Silent Bill from the Hill. Capitol Hill. Silent Bill from Capitol Hill. Hanging out in Silentville, Arizona, with the Silent Bill Foundation. Silent Bill from Capitol Hill Foundation, headquartered in Silentville, Arizona, and helping save the world. It's the new eco-revolution. Hi, my friends, I'm Silent Bill from Capitol Hill. We're all going to be silent from now on. Start a new trend of Capitol Hill silence. It's really nice that I can bring the silence up to Capitol Hill. Yeah, actually, it's a cross between Clinton and Carter. That's because I don't practice. I never practice. I haven't practiced Silent Bill from Capitol Hill since, what was it, the 80s or something? I don't know, right? He was getting his groove on in the 80s. Something like that. I don't know, maybe it was the 90s. Can't remember. Anyway, we won't be doing any more of voices like that, because he's going to be silent now. So actually, what are you doing? I'm imitating Silent Bill from Capitol Hill. Shh. Why are you so silent? I'm doing an impression of Silent Bill from Capitol Hill. Listen to this impression. Wow. He knocked that one out of the park. One of the best impressions I've ever heard. Awesome. As I say, What are you? I'm a comedian. What are you doing? I'm doing impressions of everyone. Here's a Silent Bill from Capitol Hill, and here's Silent so-and-so, and you know. Ah, wow. Yeah, I like that one. I like that one. That's really good. Nailed it. Absolutely nailed it. That was hilarious. Spot on. Who knows? He might do it. You never know. You never know. You never know. He's a good Leo. August 19th. I have the same birthday. We have the same birthday. You know, he could flip his script. You know, maybe he'll have enough of everything and say, that's it. He'd get tired of all that stuff. Dude. Come on. Let's go to Silent out here in Silentville, Arizona. You know, he went vegetarian, right? He went vegetarian, stopped eating the meat. So, you know, hey, he wants to save the planet, you know? Maybe he'll get with it. It's a good fundraiser, you know, can spread the message. Shh. Maybe the whole Congress needs to go silent. You know, he says, let me lead a silent session in Congress here. Everybody's going to have this very light silence, beautiful silence. So light, you know, the silence is just like. It's way better in prayer. They say, oh God, you want to help us, with our deliberations here and our talks and our wrangling and our compromise, and help us do the right thing. We want to try to save the planet, God. So we say our prayers to you. Let's do a meditation. Let everybody say, Om, okay, Om, 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 Om. Go do a meditation, do a power meditation. No, how about just silence, 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 silence. Positive silence, light silence. The silence of light, the silence of true light. Enjoy the silence of true light.
Senators,
enjoy the silence of the true light. How are we doing here? Yeah, doing well. Enjoy the silence of the true light. I mean, Trump's helping out. I said, Trump, how are you going to change all the health care and everything? He says, well, I don't know. I'm just going to do it. Quiet. That helps, doesn't it?
Well, you say you're going to, solve all the immigration problems. I
said, well, I'll get it done. Don't worry. Silence. I'll do a great job. No problem. I'll get a great job. Silence.
Oh, well, it's all your plan. What are your details? Yeah, I'm going to make America great again.
That's what I'm going to do. Silence.
All the pundits just say, well, where's the words? Come on, we want words. We want arguments. We want anger. We want to, what do you mean? Come on, give us some meat. Where's the red meat?
Yes. I just told you, I'm done with you. I already answered your question, I'm done with you. Silence. Okay, so let's get with the times. This is where it's at. Silence is golden, the tremolos. We didn't say stupor. No, we didn't say drug stupor. We said positive light silence. Keep that in mind, everyone. Anyone go to a drug stupor, right? Absolutely anyone can smoke some crack, go into a drug stupor. Come on. We're saying positive light silence here. Positive silence, light